Gina Jones here with the Channel 5 behind the scenes look at the Apple Valley Christmas Extravaganza, now in its 40th year. Over the years, this program has gone from being a simple Sunday school program to becoming one of our region's premier events. Every local hotel is booked full as the who's who, for our region have come together for this exciting holiday event. Tickets were sold out months ago, and behind all the extravaganza action is Norma Johnson, the director. We have a Channel 5 exclusive interview with her now. What would you say are the reasons being for this program's massive success over the years?
Well, Gina, thanks for asking. I think I would have to say working with the same actors year after year has helped us form a bond. And then, of course, some of the original actors have been here since day one doing their characters. Excuse me. That really helped them get into their own role when they do that. And every year, we tried to make it bigger and better. I would say that those two factors are the key to our success.
This event has become the region's main holiday event, to see and be seen. There are all sorts of celebrities planning to be in the audience tomorrow. Do you feel any pressure from that?
Well, of course. But seeing them react to the stories and the songs is just very rewarding. I like that our people can see the true meaning of Christmas through this program. I'm very proud of it.
I'm sure you are. Well, we'll let you get back to your work. With the final dress rehearsal starting in just a few moments, I imagine you have a lot of work to do.
Well, thank you, Gina. I'm glad that your viewers got to see a little bit of the behind-the-scenes work that we do. And I hope that they enjoy the show. Assuming, of course, they can get the tickets. Is the camera off? Are we off? Oh, good. Where is that intern? I need coffee now! Triple shot latte, hold the milk, no foam. You got that now! Ay, you people are such knuckleheads. Get my clipboard! Ugh. You maggots have no idea how much stress I have to endure year after year with this cast of whiny, self-absorbed babies. Are those green M&Ms? I specifically said no green M&Ms in my candy bowl. Oh, someone get over here and get them out. And whoever put them in, you're fired. Oh, and the things I need to endure.
Madam Director, you're wanted on the set. It's almost time to start. Here's your latte.
Okay. You work on getting the M&M's fiasco worked out. You work on getting my massage table warmed up. I have to go to work now, but when I get done, I'll need it. But there's so much pressure in knowing that I alone have the creative vision to make this happen. You all could never understand. Ugh! Oh my gosh, my lint! I can't believe these people. Oh my gosh, I just cannot believe those weasels. Oh, they just kill me. I don't know what to do with them. Oh, I don't know why I put up with this casting crew. Horrible.
Hell yeah, they're so fickle. Oh, places, everybody, places. Okay, before we run through the whole thing, I want to go through a couple of key parts. Let's start with the opening welcome. Master of Ceremony, are you ready?
Yes, I think so.
Okay, let's see it. Lights, action.
Welcome to the 40th anniversary of the Apple Valley Christmas Extravaganza.
That was okay, but I need bigger. Can you give me bigger?
I suppose.
Action.
Welcome to the 40th anniversary of the Apple Valley Extravaganza.
Oh my Lanta, is that really the best you can do?
Little Marco seems to think he can do it better.
Oh, I don't have time for this.
Please, Madam Director, I think I can do this.
Oh, all right. I'll humor you, but make it quick.
Welcome to the 40th Annual Apple Valley Christmas Extravaganza.
Perfect. I like it.
Now that's more like it. Now, let's take it from the scene where Mary and Joseph laid Jesus in the manger. Lights, are you ready?
Ready.
Well, then why is the disco ball not spinning? Bigger, better. This is supposed to be an extravaganza. Make it happen!
Yes, Director.
Okay. I'm sorry. Okay. Where is the manger?
Right here, with extra glitter, like you requested.
Well, that's more like it. Now, band, dancers, are you ready?
Ready, Madam Director.
Let's rock.
Bigger and better.
These feet were made for dancing.
Good. Because I want this song to be great. I want this song to pop. I want it to be bigger, better, bolder than ever before. You got that?
Got it, Director, but are you sure?
Well, of course I'm sure. I'm the director. I have to push you maggots to new artistic heights. You got that?
Got it.
Okay. Let's pick it up from there. Okay. Oh.
Can I do my reading now?
And song. Cut. Where's the donkey? And where's all the other manger animals? Why haven't they been here yet?
I thought you might ask about that. The donkey has some additional demands.
What kind of demands?
He said he needed to know the animals still matter to the show.
Well, of course they still matter to the show. How is Mary and Joseph supposed to get to Bethlehem without a donkey? And besides, we need him for his big song. Our audience demands their favorite Christmas song. Just give the donkey what he wants.
Okay, we're a go for Operation Rolling Herd.
Okay.
Here comes the donkey. Here comes the donkey. This ain't no donkey ride. This ain't no donkey ride. This ain't no donkey ride.
It's about time. You missed your big scene. Are you even ready for the song?
Madam Director, Donkey's always ready.
Okay.
Silent night. Holy night. All is calm. Ladies, calm. All is bright. Round yon virgin, mother and child. Holy infant, so tender and mild. Sleep in heavenly peace.
Well, Mary, you know, your tap dancing reminds me kind of a Clydesdale. And maybe it's not what it used to be.
Oh, yeah? Well, I still have it. Unlike you and your juggling routine, last time you did that, you took out a sheep.
Well, at least I know when to quit.
Ooh. I don't have that luxury. My fans demand it. I got over 60,000 YouTube hits last year.
Sure he did. I did. I posted it 12 times. Heck, you tripped twice, knocked over the manger, baby Jesus goes rolling down the walkway. I mean, it was hilarious.
Okay. Enough of this. Here's the deal. I'm the director, and I have a vision of where this show is supposed to go. And you will do what I tell you to do. Well, hello, right here, Mother of Jesus.
Oh, man.
I am the most important character in the story, and I should have a say.
This show has gone to your big head.
Ooh. Well, I never.
Well, I'll be in my trailer.
Yo-yo DK, blow on this popsicle stand. Later, Shepard.
Wait a second. He has a trailer. I want a trailer. And a big trailer. One bigger than whatever he has.
I can't work under these divisions, circumstances, whatever it is that we're working under. I can't do it anymore. I want a trailer, and I'm calling my manager. Chester.
Hey. It's the show's tomorrow night.
Chester, pick up. I want a trailer
you
right
can't
now.
Just walk out on
Chester,
me. Get back here.
Give me a trailer.
You can't walk Hurry. Out on me.
Give me
Not
a trailer.
Not on me,
Chester.
You can't.
Chester.
Actors.
Oh, my star. Those viral aerials are going to kill me, and I'm not feeling too good.
That was something.
Yeah, that happened earlier in rehearsal than last year.
Yeah, you know, it seems like the egos and the arguments are about the only thing that gets bigger and better with this show.
Yeah, I remember when it was just about the Christmas program for all this hoopla. That was sure nice.
What just happened? Mary just knocked over 3 carafes of coffee and a deli tray on her way out the door. I won't repeat what was said. I'm afraid I'm going to need some help getting this mess cleaned up. Can you help me find a really good mop?
I bet you didn't expect this when you signed up for coffee and babies, did you?
No, not really. What's happened?
Apple Community Church has developed this go big or go home to the holiday Christmas program. Quite frankly, I just want to go home.
Yeah. Tim, will you take this bag of trash for me?
Sure.
You would not believe the amount of baby mess I've had to clean up today.
Oh, I'm afraid you're not the only one.
Thanks. I need to get back. Is rehearsal almost over? I was told my schedule said 8 o'clock.
Yeah, it's over, but it might be a while before they come and get the kids. So I'm sorry to say, it's probably going to be a long night.
Good to know. Some teenager handed me this bag of green M&Ms. Do you know what that's about? It looked like they were crying, but they didn't want to talk about it.
Beats me, but nothing surprises me nowadays. Come on, I'll help you find that mop, and I got some great tile cleaner that will clean any stains on that foyer floor.
And I'll get rid of this for you, but green M&Ms are my favorite.
Really?
Oh, no. They all taste the same.
So I talked with my agent, Chester, and he said that I should have been a lot more assertive in my original negotiations. But he'll do what he can. I don't mean to brag or anything, but I'm kind of the reason people come to see the show. I am Mary, Mother of Jesus. Yes. I've been doing this role so long, I've kind of become the part. It's so cool. You can't just replace that. There's a way that I swaddle baby Jesus that just makes the audience feel the love, you know? And they just get into it. I wish everyone else wasn't so selfish, though. It just wrecks the show. Anyway, the director promised me that I would get my own dressing room trailer, one a little bit bigger than Donkey's. So I guess she's coming around. I'll put on a brave face this year because I don't want to ruin the show. It's only one day. So I will be at my best. But next year, I will come with a few more demands so I don't get overlooked so easily.
Joseph. Joseph gets overlooked in the Christmas story, but think about it. Joseph, he is the Christmas story. It's all about Joseph. I mean, without Joseph, without him believing Mary, I mean, he married her when there was reason to believe that, yeah, you know, there might have been a little something. And hey, he's also Jesus' stepdad. And you know, that's a big deal, right? And I'm going to stand up for the character. So I talked to the director, and I think she's seeing things from my perspective now. And I'm getting a trailer tomorrow. A bit bigger than Donkey's, too. And but it's not really all about the trailer or the catered lunches or the helicopter service. Nah, it's not. It's really about honoring the biblical character.
I hate seeing the rest of the cast fight. They're so worried about their roles in the play and worried about how much time they'll have in the spotlight. I understand, but they just don't understand the really important thing about tonight. And the important thing is merchandising. Their problem is they think that this is the best show they'll ever do. But I know better. This is a launching pad for greater things for me. That's why I'm not anxious at all. I sure hope the director can get things straightened out with the rest of the cast quickly, so we don't have to be here too late tonight. I have to go to my grand opening of a new Donkey brand food truck featuring my special world-famous kickin' burritos, and I feel like I need to make an appearance so that the fans will have something very awesome to remember.
This is the reason the show needs me as their main leader. The actors, they're artists. They're kind of fickle sometimes. But over the years, I have found ways to win their trust and their respect. They know I carry the vision for the whole show. They know the sacrifices I've made. They'll come around. We'll put on the best show Apple Valley has ever seen. I just know it. I just know it.
Thank you so much for being willing to help today. There is so much to be done and so little time to do it. First, we have trailer acquisition for our lead actors. Then we have M&M sorting, and I'm not exactly sure why that needs to be done, but the director wants it done. And we also have ticket customer service. All the who's who of the region are coming tonight to the big performance. And there's just so much to get done. Would you be willing to help little Marco with the M&M sorting? He's trying to do it on his own, and we're quite a bit short-handed.
I'd be glad to.
Oh, thank you so much. So much to do, so little time.
Apple Valley Community Church, can you hold me?
No, we do not have platinum seating area, just bronze, silver, and gold.
No, there is no special seating space available for your hedgehog nor your tweenie.
I'm very sorry about that, sir. Please don't yell at me. You know that seating is limited.
Where's the glitter? There's no glitter. We need more glitter.
Who was that?
Pastor Skippy. He's always making the strangest demands. Hang on. I need to take this other call. Apple Valley Community Church. Thanks for holding.
Yes, I'd like to order a 20-foot trailer delivered immediately.
I would like to order a 25-foot trailer, but it needs to be delivered right away.
On second thought, I need to make a 30-foot trailer.
Do you have any 35-foot trailers? Yeah, a 33-foot trailer would be fine, as long as it's bigger than 30 feet.
On second thought, I need to make that a 35-foot or longer trailer.
How about we both get them a 30-foot trailer and just tell each one of them that they have the larger one?
Deal. Send a 30-foot trailer right away.
Red one. Blue one, green one.
Yep, that's how you do it.
Hi there. I was wondering if anyone here could help me.
Are you looking for tickets? I'm sorry, but we're all sold out.
No, I'm not looking for tickets. My husband Joe and I were on our way to a family reunion in Idaho Falls, and our car broke down on the highway just across from the church over there.
Need glitter! Need more glitter!
I think there's more in storage room, too.
Okay, thank you.
Sorry to interrupt. There was a problem with the trailers. So apparently they're trying to get both trailers across the bridge at the same time. And, well, there was a motorcade that drove right in front of them. And then one of them swerved, and now they're both stuck, and all the traffic is blocked.
Oh, my heavens. Can you look into seeing what we can do about that? Maybe see if you can contact an industrial towing service?
I'm on it.
I'm sorry, we're saying?
Oh, I was just saying that we were on our way through town and our car broke down. My husband Joe says he thinks it's the water pump, but we're not really going
to
be sure.
I'm sorry to interrupt, but this person is asking why we don't have valet parking like we used to.
Valet.
Well, we used to have valet parking. But we decided we didn't want to do that anymore. It wasn't a good project for the middle school group.
They want to bring their own.
Well, I suppose if it's only for their own car.
Got it. Thanks.
I'm sorry, water pump, car broke down?
We called a repair company to send us a tow truck, but they said it would be a while for the tow truck to get there and then maybe a day or two for the part to come in if it is the water pump. So we're looking for a place to stay? We can pay and everything, but every other place in town we've called has been totally booked. Do you have any ideas on what we can do? I'm kind of needing to get off of my feet soon.
Oh, I see that. Yes.
I'm sorry to interrupt, but I just heard it directly from the director's husband that now the director only wants magenta colored M&Ms. There's just one tiny problem with that.
What's that?
There are no magenta colored M&Ms. What do I do? She'll have my head.
Oh. I'm sorry. You've come on a very bad day.
I picked up on that. I don't mean to be a bother.
Has anybody seen that Star brand tile and grout cleaner? I've got some stains on the foyer floor, and I can't find it anywhere. It's urgent.
Okay. I think I saw some back in the other storage closet. You come with me, and we'll talk to the director and work out a candy solution, and then we'll come back with the cleaner. All the rest of you just keep doing what you're doing. And can somebody please find... I'm sorry, I didn't even find out your name.
Marianne. My friends call me Mary.
Can somebody please find Mary a chair?
I'll get a chair. Be right back.
No, and I'm not sure what we're supposed to do. This trip has turned out to be so much more stressful than I thought. And I'm not feeling too well.
Are you okay, dear? You don't look so good.
Oh, dear. I think my water just broke.
Oh, dear. What do we do?
Oh, dear. We need to get you somewhere quiet. Come with me. Colleen, I need some emergency medical advice.
So I call Pauline. She has a bunch of experience in first aid. We timed the contractions, and they were very close together. We called for an ambulance, but because of the traffic jam, we didn't know if we were going to get through or not. Pauline walked us through getting things ready just in case the doctor and paramedics couldn't get through in time. So I called Nicole.
I was at work when I got the call. I did the best I could to talk to Patricia and Nicole through finding the hand sanitizer and the hand towels and getting some warm water. It's hard to do that and take orders from the coffee drive-thru. I guess someone made some complaints, but when I explained what was going on to my boss, he was really nice about it.
My motorcade had just gone over the bridge, and there was this ruckus behind me. A couple of trailers had some sort of an accident. Anyway, we pulled into a drive-through coffee stand, and I ordered a non-fat latte with extra whipped cream. The barista was very distracted and talking on the phone, and she'd simply messed it up. Now, I understand that that can happen, but I made a complaint to the management, and I certainly didn't leave her a tip. And I hope that in the future she can be more attentive to what needs to be done for her customers.
Things got really intense. Marion was going into labor, and fast. Timothy and Joe moved in a cot and some soft chairs from the middle school room into a storage room and cleaned everything up as best they could. Nicole tried to keep Marion calm, and Pauline talked us through it over the phone. Timothy tried keeping Joe calm. We all just pulled together.
It was intense. There was like a baby coming.
Yeah, Joe fainted, I think. I caught him before he hit the ground and moved him to a chair and stayed with him till he calmed down.
It was beautiful.
Miraculous.
A baby boy.
Well, I guess we'll get out of here now. Let you guys get some rest. It's kind of busy in the rest of the building, but you should be safe here, and it's quiet.
I'll be around for you if you need anything. I wish we could have offered you something more.
I'll bring you some more baby clothes and a few more blankets.
Thank you all so much. We really appreciate it. Our son came a little bit sooner than we were expecting, but thanks to you, he's healthy and amazing.
Thank you guys so much. You've been so generous to us.
Glad to. We'll check back in a bit.
Hey there, little man.
I was just thinking, have we thought of a name for certain?
I was thinking we should go with the name we decided on before. Your great-grandfather's name.
Joseph. He does look like a Joseph. Welcome to the world, Joe. I was just wondering.
Sure.
Does anyone mind if I play this?
Child, holy infant, so tender.
That's the way it is.
Well, I know. I don't get it. I know you're still upset about the trailers. There's nothing I can do about it. But I do have some massage tables I can do for you.
Well, I'm just tired of being overlooked. I think you should do more for your star.
Star? Maybe in your dreams.
Oh. Hey,
are they good massage tables?
Shh. There's one in here.
Christ the Savior is born. Christ the Savior is born.
Isn't that adorable? That is so cute.
Silent night, holy night, Son of God, God's pure light, radiant beams from thy holy. With the dawn of redeeming grace, Christ the Savior is born. Christ the Savior is born.
Sleep well, little Joseph. We thank God for you.
I think I have something in my eye.
Yeah, me too.
Oh, it's just adorable.
So that's when I started thinking, maybe I've been taking things in the wrong direction.
Right there, I thought, maybe it's not all about me.
And I remember thinking, maybe it's time for something different.
I've heard about their experience, and I think they've totally lost their mind.
Maybe we need to get back to basics, to the simple message, without all the bigger, better, bolder.
Maybe the story's about God sending his son to earth to serve people in their greatest need. I think sometimes we miss that in all the activity.
You know, we get so busy that we miss the things that God's doing right under our noses.
Then I called the other actors, and they agreed to make some changes in the production. Well, most of them did.
Huh.
I stayed up late that night, shifting things around in the script and the blocking notes. My husband had a lot of good ideas. Maybe I should have listened to him all along. Anyway, the show won't be what everybody expects, but I think it'll be good.
Good evening. Welcome to the 40th annual Apple Valley Christmas Extravaganza. We've made a few changes to what we've done in the past, but I think you're going to like it.
Excuse me? Hi. Could I say something?
Yes, of course. Ladies and gentlemen, Director Norma Johnson.
Thank you. You know, we work hard on this play, and every year we try to make things bigger and better than the year before. But I've come to see that bigger isn't always better. After seeing baby Joshua born, I feel a little ashamed of the way I treated all of you. Christmas isn't about presents and all the hoopla and bigger, better. It's about the birth of Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. So we all got together, we made some changes in the play, and brought it back to basics. And I hope you enjoy it. Thank you.
Thank you. Let's give her a big round of applause for all the work on this. Thank you, Norma. And now, ladies and gentlemen, we present to you the Apple Valley Christmas Extravaganza.
Oh,
In those days, Caesar Augustus issued a decree that there should be a census of the entire Roman world. This was the first census when Quirinius was the governor in Syria. And everyone was required to return to his own town.
And Joseph went up from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to Bethlehem, the town of David, because he was in the line and the house of David. He went there to register with Mary, who was pledged to marry him and was with child.
While they were there, the time came for the baby to be born, and she gave birth to her firstborn, a son. She wrapped him in cloths and put him in a manger because there was no guest room available to them. Shepherds in the fields nearby, keeping watch over their flock at night. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them,
"Do not be afraid, for I bring you good news that will cause great joy to all the people. Today in the town of David, the Savior has been born, the Messiah of the Lord. Let this be a sign to you. You will find a babe wrapped in cloth, lying in a manger."
And suddenly a great company of heavenly hosts appeared with the angel, praising God and saying,
"Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace to those on whom his favor rests."
And when the angels had left them and went into heaven, the shepherds said to one another,
"Let's go to Bethlehem to see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has told to them."
So they hurried off and found Mary and Joseph and the baby, who was lying in a manger. When they had seen him, they spread the word concerning what had been told to them about the child, and all who heard their shepherd's story were amazed. But Mary treasured up all these things and pondered them in her heart.
Holy Father,
Do you wonder as you watch my face if a wiser one should have had?
The shepherds heard the angel's message, and they immediately went looking for Jesus, finding him in lowly circumstances. Today, as the message from heaven, we too can find Jesus if we set aside our distractions and look for him. And just as the shepherds found baby Jesus in a humble manger, we too can find Jesus if we humble ourselves and ask for his help.
This Christmas, we pray that you will receive the greatest gift ever, the gift that God gave when he sent his son, Jesus Christ, to be our Savior. And it truly is a gift, for all we have to do is be willing to receive it and pray to Jesus to save us from our sins and make us new people.
And as that gift grows in you, God's light continuously shines through you to those around you, especially to those who need his love the most.
That's what Christmas is all about, the love of Jesus.
In a humble stable, with a manger for his bed, the Son of God, our Savior, drew his first breath. The shepherds watched in wonder, promise was fulfilled, and the heavens rang with praises for the Savior of the world. Come and see Christ the King. God so loved the world that his only Son he gave, the greatest gift of all. There is no greater love than this baby born to save. And when we know Jesus, it's Christmas every day. Come and see Christ the King. God so loved the world that His only Son He gave, the greatest gift of all, sleeping in the hay. There is no greater love than this baby born to save. And when we know Jesus, it's Christmas every day.
My trailer.
Thank you, everyone. Could we please have Laura Fox, Lauren, Andrew, and Brittany up here, please? Wow, it got quiet fast. We just wanted to take a minute to thank the creative geniuses behind this, Lauren and Andrew that wrote the play, and Laura and Brittany that made it happen. So thank you so much, you guys. We really appreciate it.